Hey everyone, this is Lucky over on Pow Pow Island. Wow, did you guys just blow up my channel or what? How exciting. Talk about so many amazing comments and questions. So here goes. We're going to talk orchard planning. Why this and why that? Let's talk about the 4x4 setup here and let's talk about mine. So Adam Kelly asked a great question. He said to me, why are you not using this system with the trees on the corners versus the one that I'm using? Oh, get out of my way, little character. aren't I just so mean? Why am I using this one? And here's what I showed you in the very first video. I said to you that fruit has to be, in my orchard, needs to be planted 3x3 apart. So three holes always separate each piece of fruit that I plant, which makes a tree. So it looks like this. It looks like this. Tree, three holes, tree, three holes, tree. Then the next row would have no planting, and then the following row would be on the alternate. But to do this for the very first time, you've never planted a tree, so now you're saying, oh my God. I also want to give a little scolding out, not a shout out, but a scolding out to Nintendo. I would have figured you'd have been advanced enough to put a grid pattern on the ground if we wanted it. There should be a button that says you want the grid. And then I could have this all gridded out so I knew where the squares were. So I've had to do this manually myself, and that's sort of why I'm showing this. You need to do this if you're going to be efficient with straight lines and stuff, because it's so easy to be off center. You're going to basically do this one here for your first try if you'd like to follow my orchard pattern. It's tree, space, 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 tree, space, 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 tree, space, 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 tree, and then again. And then once you've got that outer border, you're going to pop one in the center. So now you'll have what looks like this. And after that, you can walk in any direction you want and just count three holes and plant a tree. Three holes, plant a tree. Three holes, plant a tree. Three holes, it doesn't matter. Just three holes between every tree. Now, why do I choose to do that for my big orchard? My big industrial orchard is that way. Here I've done one, like a lot of people are doing, is just two apart, row by row. This is a 2x2, and when I use that term 2x2, it's a four grid, but it's only two hole spacing. So mine's a 3x3, three holes, three holes, and this is 2x2. Okay, that's just me and my terminology. Here's a little tidbit. When you're planting a tree, drop a piece of fruit next to it. You'll always know what it is until it grows. That's perfect for when they're little. Okay, another thing before I head to my orchard, why did this tree not grow? It's because this is a hole right here, and a tree will not grow next to an object. It won't grow next to your buildings. It won't grow next to your rivers. You must always have one hole spacing around a tree. So these ones grew, this one didn't. Now you're going to say, well, you're not following your own rule. Where's the little fruit? They're coming. I just have to go to my orchard and get pears. These are all pear trees to replace the five orange trees. All right, let's just go quickly over to my orchard, because I want to explain why my grid works for me and for you to think about this. First of all, a little tip. Because of where I'm located, I sometimes need a spare axe, so I always leave one in the ground. And how do you get it standing? Pretty straightforward. You pick your item that you want to put on the ground, and you say place the item instead of dropping. If you drop it, it goes like that. If you place it, it actually then stands up. So let's just get rid of that for a moment, and off we go. So the other thing about your orchard, now when you're shaking trees or hitting trees with your axe, you do not need power for those two items. You need to be, we can have power, pardon me, I'm going to rephrase that. You need power when you want to use your flimsy or stone axe to get speed. You don't want power when you are hitting rocks, if you want to get the goodies out of your rock. So that, just to clarify that. So as you can see, your speed or your power is indicated up here. If you want to uproot a tree and replant it, you can replant a whole tree wherever you want. You can. That's something that I just want to share. So if I want to go ahead and take this tree here, I can just say plant. I don't even need my shovel. And there it is. You can plant the full tree. I've noticed that there was a comment saying that, well, why don't you just plant the whole orchard with already set up trees? But I have 37 trees here. And just take a look. You do not have 37 spaces to, well, you probably do if you don't have all your junk with you, so you could just have nothing but full trees. But I went over to an island, and I just went ahead, and I got the fruit, and you can 10 per slot, so then I just went around and planted the orchard from scratch. Okay, so that's enough of that. Now, here is something that is important. Why do I choose this orchard? It's because, and why do I choose them on the diagonal? Let's just get an overview. Okay, so you can see me walking. I can see myself wandering around. I'm not lost in literally treetops, okay? Now, this is the other thing. So let's just stand behind this center tree. Remember we talked about the four trees and the one in the center. Tree, three spaces, etc. I'm going to zoom in and show you what it looks like. Today I actually used my stone axe. Do not use this axe. This axe gives you three hits and you will cut your tree down on that third hit. So two cuts and then the third one, it cuts your tree down. You want to use stone or flimsy, okay? And during this time, I did have more power, so I was a little bit more efficient. So I went through my orchard. I didn't do all of it, but most of it. And I actually need to stand behind this one because I want to only show you the trees here that are not with fruit. When I hit them all on the same side. I went along, and what you get is this kind of a thing here. Let's zoom in now. So I actually want to zoom in a little bit further, so I'll stand there. It gets rid of that one tree. Can you see the pattern now? I hit the tree, the fruit comes down first, and so does one piece of wood on that first hit with the axe, the stone axe. The second hit gives me another piece of wood, and the third gives me the last piece of wood. So all of my stuff is there on each tree. So this grid allows all of the merchandise to land on the ground and I don't lose any. When you start tightening these trees up and you want to be efficient and go through, you will lose some of your wood and possibly fruit if it's one by one. Now let me just explain that. One more. Oh, and by the by, the cherry tree is just a marker. I had a little dud tree here. I uprooted it, put the cherry in there as a placement tree. Tomorrow I'll see if the tree is still there. I'm not sure if there's an actual glitch in the system. But let us now just get the ladder out, and I will just show you what my secondary orchard, my orange tree orchard, looks like. These are still small, so you can see how big they're going to get, right? This is going to be crowded, but I can still walk behind all of them. That's important. So there's a space back there. And then there's a space in front, an empty row in front. But please note, I still do the alternate. I have not chosen to put these back to back. This is something that gives you a chance to see your trees better. Excuse me. On the zoom in, this is another thing. When you're on a second level, like I am here, I can now see what's on the ground. If these trees were back to back, it's a little harder to see what's around them. So, oh, look at that, I'm missing a present. So while I chose up here just to do two rows with one spacing, I actually find it's fine for up here, but I will not be able to do multitasking. I will not be able to hit and get all the goodies at one time. Now, why did I not put a tree right here? Well, because unfortunately it dents in and this tree would die because it would be too close on this row. So that's part of the mapping out of stuff, is you do have to take a minute to see where the holes are going to line up and grid your system like that. All right, I hope, well, let's just grab my ladder and tuck it away. Oh. No, you want to go, you don't want to climb. Okay, there we go. Now I can tuck it away. All right, so at this stage of the game, I hope that explains why I chose to do my orchard the way I did. And if you have any questions or more concerns or feedback, by all means, I will find out what that cherry tree does and let you all know. In the meantime, hey guys, thanks so much for subscribing. That was pretty cool. I woke up to quite a few people there. Thank you, that's fun. In this time of self-isolation with this coronavirus, I have a lot of joy and happiness playing my game, and you've added to that by adding your lovely comments, your kind words, and I appreciate that. So thank you so very much. Have yourselves a wonderful time on your island, and I hope this was a bit more clarifying for those of you that had so many questions there. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.